Why is sound doctrine so important? The answer for this question is taken from godquestions.com. Paul charges Titus, "You must teach what is in accord with sound doctrine." Such a mandate makes it clear that sound doctrine is important. But why is it important? Does it really make a difference what we believe? Sound doctrine is important because our faith is based on a specific message. The overall teaching of the church contains many elements, but the primary message is explicitly defined as Christ died for our sins according to the scriptures. He was raised on the third day according to the scriptures. This we read it in 1 Corinthians 15 chapter verses 3 and 4. This is a clear good news and it is of first importance. Change that message and the basis of faith shifts from Christ to something else. Ephesians 1:3 says our eternal destiny depends upon hearing the word of truth, the gospel of your salvation. Sound doctrine is important because the gospel is a sacred trust. And we dare not tamper with God's communication to the world. Our duty is to deliver the message, not to change it. In Jude 1:3, conveys an urgency in guarding the trust. It says, "I felt I had to write and urge you to contend for the faith that was once for all entrusted to the saints." To contend carries the idea of fighting for something constantly, to give it everything you have got. Revelation 22:18 and 19 says that the Bible includes a warning neither to add nor subtract from God's word. Rather than alter the apostles' doctrine, we receive what has been passed down to us and keep it as a pattern of sound teaching with faith and love in Christ Jesus. So says Paul in 2 Timothy chapter 1 and verse 13. Sound doctrine is important because what we believe affects what we do. Behavior is an extension of theology. And there is a direct correlation between what we think and how we act. For example, two people stand on top of a bridge. One believes he can fly and the other believes he cannot fly. Their next actions will be quite dissimilar. In the same way, a man who believes that there is no such thing as right and wrong will naturally behave differently from a man who believes in well-defined moral standards. In one of the Bible's list of sins, things like rebellion, murder, lying, and slave trading are mentioned. This list concludes with whatever else is contrary to sound doctrine. We read this in 1 Timothy 1 chapter verses 9 and 10. In other words, true teaching promotes righteousness. Sin flourishes where the sound doctrine is opposed. Sound doctrine is important because we must ascertain truth in a world of falsehood. 1 John 4:1 says, "Many false prophets have gone out into the world." Matthew 13:25 says there are tares among the wheat and wolves among the flock. The best way to distinguish truth from falsehood is to know what the truth is. Sound doctrine is something important because the end of sound doctrine is life. In 1 Timothy 4:16, we read, "Watch your life and doctrine closely. Persevere in them, because if you do, you will save both yourself and your hearers. Conversely, the end of unsound doctrine is destruction. Certain men whose condemnation was written about long ago have secretly slipped in among you. They are godless men who change the grace of our God into a license for immorality and deny Jesus Christ, our only sovereign Lord. This we read it in Jude 1:4. Changing God's message of grace is a godless thing to do, and the condemnation for such a deed is severe. Sound doctrine is important because it encourages believers. A love for God's word brings great peace. Psalm 119 verse 165 says that, "And those who proclaim peace, who proclaim salvation, are truly beautiful." We read this in Isaiah 52nd chapter verse 7. A pastor must hold firmly to the trustworthy message as it has been taught, so that he can encourage others by sound doctrine and refute those who oppose it. Titus 1:9. In Proverbs 22nd chapter 28th verse, we read, "Do not remove the ancient landmark which your fathers have set." If we can apply this to sound doctrine, the lesson is that we must preserve it intact. May we never stray from the simplicity that is in Christ. Thank you for listening. God bless you.